Most incredible animal fossils ever found. Hey everyone, it's Alexa and welcome back to another video. From giant ants and dinosaur mummies to hobbit-sized humanoids, here are 13 of the most incredible animal fossils ever found. But before we get into today's video, make sure that you're subscribed and ring the bell so that you never miss any of our upcoming videos. Giant prehistoric ants. If you have a phobia about ants or you're allergic to them, like me, it's a good thing you weren't around some 50 million years ago. That's when a genus of huge winged ants known as Titanomyra existed. Their fossils have been located in Wyoming, where it is the first fossil of a giant ant unearthed in the Western Hemisphere. Some species could measure nearly 2.5 inches long and had a wingspan of 6 inches. That would have been about the size of hummingbirds. Experts say that would make the insects the largest giant ants that ever existed. Oldest reptile live birth. Birth can be a dangerous process for any animal, even one as big as a bus. Ichthyosaurs were giant prehistoric sea predators that went extinct around 90 million years ago. A fossil discovery made in China in 2011 displayed a female ichthyosaur that had perished while giving birth. Analysis revealed that she was carrying 3 offspring, with one of them emerging halfway. That made this specimen unique because it proved the ancient marine reptiles birthed their babies head first. Estimated at some 248 million years old, paleontologists say this is the oldest known fossil of a reptilian live birth. The horned horse. There isn't much information on this animal, but it sounds so unusual that we had to include it. Synthetoceras was a creature that inhabited the plains of North America during the late Miocene, 10 to 5 million years ago. While some sources refer to it as a horse, it was more closely related to the modern camel. Its most unique feature was the foot-long horn that branched into a small V-shape at the end. It also had a pair of horns positioned behind its eyes, which only the males possessed. The horns may have been used for sparring when competing for females. The Laetoli footprints. When they were initially discovered in Tanzania in 1976, these tracks were dated to the Pliocene at around 3.7 million years ago, making them the oldest such fossils known. Older specimens have subsequently been located, but these footprints were the first to offer convincing evidence of bipedalism among hominins, or prehistoric creatures that were closely related to humans. The discovery of the fossils ended the debate whether larger brains or bipedalism developed first in the timeline of human evolution. These hominins were fully bipedal at least 1 million years before the first stone tools were created. Experts say the footprints were preserved in volcanic ash, where they were found at a site in Tanzania called Laetoli. The scorpion spider. Around 100 million years ago, an arachnid existed that could nearly pass as a spider and scorpion hybrid. Paleobiologists found the creature's remains preserved in Burmese amber in Myanmar. The specimen had a body length of 2.5 millimeters, while its tail measured about 3 millimeters. But this small critter presented some big questions for experts. Their whip-like tails are similar to those of the present-day whip scorpions, which are not true scorpions either. But these ancient, mysterious arachnids did possess several traits typical of true spiders, including spinnerets to create silk. So these newly unearthed animals could be an example of a Lazarus taxon with no fossil record. Or they might have belonged to an extinct group that shared some similar origins of spiders. In any case, the arachnids could prove that spider-like creatures with tails existed alongside true spiders 200 million years ago. Frankenstein fossils. Some strange fossils were found in Brazil that date to around 120 million years old. Mysterious monster bugs exhibited physical characteristics from unrelated insect groups. These creatures had the body and wings of a dragonfly, the forelegs of a praying mantis, and wing veins similar to those of a mayfly. The 2 adults and 40 larval fossils discovered around the world have been dubbed Frankenstein insects due to their weird mashup of characteristics. Thanks to that, researchers created a new order for this species. The newly discovered group existed during the Cretaceous period. While they weren't thought to have any modern-day descendants, experts think their closest relatives are mayflies. Microraptors. At around 2.5 feet long and weighing just over 2 pounds, these dinos existed around 120 million years ago and were well named. Microraptors are regarded as the smallest non-avian dinosaurs known to date. They've been described as four-winged dinosaurs with one set of wings on their forelimbs and the other set on the hind limbs. They also had feathers, which makes them helpful in determining the evolutionary relationship between dinos and modern-day birds. Experts say these animals could probably glide, but it's still unknown if they were capable of true flight. Hundreds of their fossils have been discovered in China in excellent condition. Euteranus. These dinos lived during the early Cretaceous, some 125 million years ago. Fossils discovered in northeast China in 2012 revealed a very unusual beast. The theropods were covered with feathers that measured around 20 centimeters long. Experts say the feathers probably helped the animal regulate its body temperature since it lived in a fairly frigid climate. It would have measured around 7.5 meters and weighed more than 1,400 kilos. There's still a debate as to the color of its feathers. But while the color is unknown, it is for certain that these were the largest dinosaurs known, with direct evidence of feathers. Mongolian mashup. What's the weirdest dinosaur ever? Well, some fossils were found in Mongolia's Gobi Desert that are said to bear similar features to ducks and swans. And it may have even walked like a penguin. Dating back 75 million years, it's known as the Halska Raptor and has been classified as a dinosaur. Even so, some paleontologists say this specimen represents an entirely new species. Going about the size of a goose or mallard duck, the animal had a slender, curved neck, a duck-like bill, and a long tail. Despite its bird-like features, it was a non-avian dinosaur, closely related to the Velociraptor, with razor-sharp claws and crocodilian teeth. While scientists have learned much about it already, it seems this critter still has a lot of secrets yet to be revealed. Helicoprion. Fossils of this unusual beast are distinguished by its tooth whorl, which resembles a circular saw. The creature is nicknamed the spiral saw because of that. The genus was first described in 1899, and their remains have been found from North America, Asia, and Australia. They were shark-like animals that existed around 290 million years ago, and experts say they would have been some big critters. There's evidence to suggest they may have measured 40 feet long. That's based on a tooth whorl that would have measured about 24 inches in length. The whorl's pattern is thought to represent teeth in the animal's lower jaw. As it matured, older, smaller teeth were positioned into its center as newer, larger teeth grew in. Paleontologists are still debating how the creature would have fed itself. One popular theory says that the Helicoprion used its flexible jaw like a whip to lash into schools of fish and retrieve whatever it impaled. A dino named Sue. Sue is actually the nickname given to the fossil of a tyrannosaur that was unearthed in South Dakota in 1990. The find is extraordinary because more than 90% of the fossil was recovered. That makes it the most extensive and best preserved specimen of a T-Rex ever found. Experts estimate that Sue would have measured some 40 feet long, about 12 meters, and weighed over 20 US tons, or 18 metric tons. So why was it called Sue? Because the creature was nicknamed for Sue Hendrickson, the explorer who first discovered it. It's on permanent display at the Field Museum of Natural History in Chicago. Dinosaur mummy. When the remains of a mummified nodosaur were found in a mine in Alberta, Canada, it was hailed as the best preserved dinosaur specimen ever unearthed, and it's hard to argue that point. Dating back around 110 million years, the mummified nodosaur still had its skin and armor plating still intact. Even some of its guts were well preserved. The creature was a huge four-legged herbivore that would have weighed some 3,000 pounds and measured 18 feet long. In addition to bony plates of armor, the animal was also protected by two spikes measuring 20 inches that thrust from its shoulders. Paleontologists have compared the spikes to a misplaced pair of bull's horns. When it comes to dino fossils, only bones and teeth are usually found intact. This specimen's exceptional condition is thought to have resulted from spending millions of years on the ocean floor, where minerals preserved it. Flores man. Skeletal remains of this hominin were found in 2003 on the island of Flores in Indonesia and was soon nicknamed the Hobbit. The reference to J.R.R. Tolkien's works was due to the size of the specimen discovered. He would have only stood around 3.5 feet tall and weighed less than 60 pounds, about the estimated size of Middle Earth inhabitants. While skeletal remains were dated to around 100,000 years old, stone tools found with the remains were nearly twice as old. Researchers say the reason for the specimen's small body and brain size might be traced to the island's limited food sources, resulting in a type of insular dwarfism. This has yet to be determined, as does their scientific classification. It's still undecided whether or not Flores Man represents a species that is distinct from modern humans.